I know that you're very passionate about, you know, designing and everything, but what else is there? There has to be something else that drives you to want to get up every day, to come in and do endless hours on designing and things like that, so.
People would ask me what my inspiration is really, yeah. But then I would sometimes really just answer them. It's like, really, I think more of passion than inspiration. Of course, I work because I also need to work, but I mean, it's just what I fell in love doing. I mean, mm-hmm. Meeting clients, my staff, mm-hmm. my family, you know, everything just goes into one house, which is this one. Mm-hmm. Everything just works. You know, it's like a family, you know. It just like feels like home.
Yeah. How many staff members do you have here?
We're probably 25, I would
say. Oh,
wow. And yeah, now we're growing. Mm-hmm. So everything's happening so fast. Everything mm-hmm. happens so fast.
You seem to have a really good support system behind you, which is great. I feel like everybody needs that. Do you have a significant other?
Yeah.
You do? Are you public about him or?
It's at some point probably. Yeah. I mean, he's been with me since I was studying.
Oh gosh, okay.
Yeah, I was studying. And he's the one actually helping me the business side of it.
Okay.
He's handling the back end of this.
Okay.
So yeah, he's kind of my backbone.
It's good.
The business, yeah. And it's not just him, it's also my family, my daughter. My daughter, I think I owe a lot to her too.
Your daughter, her name's Alexa, right? How old is she?
She's 13.
She's 13 and you're 25.
Yes.
So you had her at a really, really young age.
Yeah.
So talk to me about being a young mother.
Well, of course, I think I had tons of struggles with that. But as I always tell people, you know, I wouldn't be where I am right now if I didn't have her or I didn't go through those things. Mm-hmm. Yeah, but everything just
happens for a reason. Having a child at such a young age, do you think that kind of dimmed the lights of being able to be a fashion designer? Did you think at any stage, oh my goodness, this is never going to happen for me?
I don't think ever it's because of being a fashion designer. If ever there's something about it, it would be probably my personal life. Like, mm-hmm. Of course, I do have extra responsibilities already at a young age. I couldn't do things I would want to do because I'm not alone anymore, you know, I already mm-hmm. have like a partner, mm-hmm. you know. So I think it's more of the personal things. But being a fashion designer, you know, I think it's more of how people thought I can't do things anymore.
Mm, because you're a mom?
Yeah.
Really?
Well, I think that's how society naturally is, you know. I mean,
do you feel like they boxed you into this certain category and they just went, okay?
Yeah. Yeah, and it happened so fast. I was young, mm-hmm. and the rumors and everything that people, I think it's normal. Mm-hmm. But when you're in a situation, it's not normal.
Yeah. How did you deal with that?
I think I showed everyone a tough face then. Mm-hmm. You know, I pretended to be really, really tough and strong.
Okay.
And, but yeah, I think it also prepared me for my industry now.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Gave you thick skin,
yeah.
Which we all need thick skin in this
exactly.
industry, right?
True.
I also feel like that it made you more resilient, you know, in a sense that there are a lot of people who will say a lot of bad things about you. You've got great designs, you've really great designs, and then behind your back they're like, those designs aren't that.
For sure, I mean, for sure. You know, I think God placed me in a situation that prepared me for my future.
Okay, so when it comes to, you know, designing and personal life and love life and being a mother and being a daughter and being everything. What do you think makes up Patty Ang?
Yeah, there are times at this point that, you know, I don't want to get up and work. I think it's more of time. Mm-hmm. You know, I don't have time for myself. Mm-hmm. Sometimes I don't have time for my family, my daughter, mm-hmm. my fiance, and mm-hmm. they complain honestly until this day, but you know, I would always think that I'm here. I mean, should I slow down or should I get moving?
No.
I'm just really enjoying what I do right now. Mm-hmm. And what's always on my mind is, you mm-hmm. know, reality bites. It's not going to happen forever anyway. I'm just thankful that everyone behind me really understands me, especially mm-hmm. my fiancé, you know.
Credit to you, Patty. You know, you're 25. You have this amazing business. you've been able to keep your personal life under wraps, as well as what you were saying, you know, you're a public figure as well. So, you know, round of applause to you, because for 25-year-old girls out there, you know, you're such an inspiration for these young women.
But I have a long way to go, you know.
Everybody says that. Everybody's a work in progress. Yeah. You know, everybody, it's about day by day working on yourself and, you know, and wanting to become a better version of themselves. Mm-hmm. If you could say something to a much younger Patty, because you're so young as it is, what would your advice be?
Yeah, probably won't let the struggles get into you. Mm-hmm. People will be constantly pulling you down no matter how high you are already, and it's never gonna stop, right? It's never gonna stop. So, you know, just do what you think is right, as long as it's right. Just keep on going and you'll reach your dreams, you know?
Winning feels great, but it's not what drives me to perform at every game. It's about getting better, getting stronger, and becoming the best that I can be. Hi guys, I'm Eliza Valdez, a professional volleyball player. It's really overwhelming. I really didn't thought of anything like this. And all I did when I was a kid was to really train hard, listen to my coaches, and I'm just really happy and I'm really blessed to be here in front of you guys. Here, I feel empowered when I'm inside the court, when I get to show other people my talent, and I get to share my talent also to young kids. All I can say is everyone really starts from scratch, and we can really get anything in just a snap. Hindi naman gumagalang ang isang athlete or magaling ang isang tao sa isang tulog lang. It's really a process. Kahit ako, I really don't know how to play volleyball before. Well, it's human nature to feel the pressure, not only because of the people around me, but for myself also, because I really want to make it to a point that I perform at my best every game, and I play for not only for my teammates, for my coaches, but because of God. That's why every time I'm inside the court, I feel the pressure, I get nervous, but at the end of the day, I'm here, I'm playing the sport because I love it. When I was a kid, when I was in high school and in college, I always hear my coaches, my teammates, that winning is about getting the championship, getting all these awards. But at the end of the day, it's the values I get because of sport. And the teaching of my coaches, my teammates also, ang nadadala ko outside of the court. That's why failure is not an option. You just have to always try after. Siyempre, it's always possible, it's always may matatalo, may mananalo, but it's always the lesson. So I think it's not failure, it's just always learning and getting back on your feet after any defeat. Look up, aim high, live boldly.